Have you ever wondered if meteorites fall to Earth all the time, and they do, thousands every year, how would you know if a rock in your backyard is a rock from space or just a regular Earth rock? Today, we will learn about all of this and more with my experiment, Space Slime. Hi everyone, I'm Emily Calandrelli, MIT engineer and host of Emily's Wonder Lab, and on my channel we learn about all things space and science. So grab your magnets and your glue because we're about to make slime that is out of this world. While it would be pretty rare to come across a meteorite in your backyard, there is one easy way to test if a rock originated from space, and that is with a magnet. Most meteorites originate from asteroids, and most asteroids have a high percentage of iron in them. And the cool thing about iron is that it is ferromagnetic, which means it's attracted to a magnet. So most space rocks, most meteorites, will be this attracted to a magnet because of the iron inside them. Regular Earth rocks, they don't do that. Today we are going to use the power of iron to create magnetic slime. For this one, you need 1/3 cup of glue, 2 tablespoons of water, 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda, a spoon and a bowl to mix it all in, a strong magnet, 2 tablespoons of iron filings, this is the secret to our magnetic slime, and then 3/4 tablespoon contact solution. Make sure it's the kind with boric acid. So let's go ahead with our glue. We need 1/3 cup of glue, right here. You'll notice the glue is really runny and flowy. That's because glue is a polymer. That means it's made up of long repeating chains of molecules that flow past each other really easily. Now let's add our 2 tablespoons of water and our 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda. And just mix that all in so that you don't see any more clumps. Now we're gonna add our 2 tablespoons of iron filings. Parents and adults, make sure you do this one because this can get messy very quickly. And finally, we are going to add our contact solution. This is going to cross-link those molecules in our polymer, making it less flowy and runny and more viscous and slimy. So we're gonna go ahead and add that in, and you'll notice it right away become more slimy with every turn. This is our slime. Make sure you get all the glue on the sides. Look at that. And eventually, you're just gonna wanna get your hands in there and mix it just like that. I promise you it gets less sticky the more you mix it. Perfect. So now, what you wanna do is get your magnet. This is the fun part. And get, whoa! Oh no, no! It ain't my magnet! Well, it's very attracted to a magnet. It just ate mine. So we're gonna wanna try to free our magnet from our slime. This one gets, I told you it would get messy, this one gets a little messy. Okay, get off of my magnet. Okay, I'm gonna try to do this again. Get your magnet really close to your slime and watch what happens. It comes alive. That's because those iron filings are ferromagnetic, which makes it attracted to what? A magnet, right? And so we can make our slime come alive. So the iron filings in our space slime are attracted to a magnet, just like the iron in a meteorite is attracted to a magnet. The stronger the magnet you have, the more the effect will be obvious. Parents and adults, just be careful with strong magnets. They can pinch fingers and you wanna make sure you keep them away from all your electronics. Thanks for making Space Slime with me. If you like this one, be sure to check out my best-selling Stay Curious and Keep Exploring series for 99 more science experiments. I'm Emily Calandrelli. Subscribe to learn about all things science and space. And remember, stay curious and keep exploring. We'll see you next time. Emily's Science Lab.